Hi, welcome to my channel Agri Entomology Tutors. If you are watching my video for the first time, please subscribe the channel and click on the bell button to get all the notification of uploaded videos. Today we will discuss about the locust management, as because the locust swarm, that two desert locust entered to India in Rajasthan and Maharashtra and also near the Maharashtra and Karnataka border. Hence, management of this locust swarm is very important in saving crop. Before knowing about the management of locust, what is mean by locust? Locusts are the collection of a certain species of the shorthorn grasshopper, which mainly belongs to the family Acridae, which having a swarming phase. These insects are usually solitary, but under certain circumstances they become more abundant and change their behavior and habit, then become to gregarious form. What is difference between the locust and grasshopper? There is no taxonomic difference between the locust and grasshoppers, but these locusts are the large group of insects of commonly of grasshoppers. In case of this locust, the hind legs are big as compared to the grasshoppers for jumping purpose or for swarming purpose. But in case of this locust, which have an ability to change their behavior and habits, and they can migrate over a large distance. These are the some of the list of different locusts. For example, the desert locust, Cystocera gregaria, Bombay locust, Nomadocris succincta, migratory locust, Locusta migratoria, Italian locust, Calyptemus italicus, Moroccan locust, Dosiosaurus moroccanus, red locust, Nomadocris septem faciata, brown locust, Locustana pardalina, South American locust, Cystocera paranensis, Australian locust, Cartoisitis terminifera, and the last one is tree locust, Anacridium species. Out of these different locusts, the desert locust is one of the important pest in India as well as international context. The four locust species which are mainly noticed in India are, one is desert locust, migratory locust, Bombay locust, and the last one is tree locust. With respect to the life cycle, it consisting of the three stages. One is egg stage and another one is the hopper stage or nymphal stage, which mainly consisting of 5 to 6 larval mounds, and adult stage, which is mainly involved in swarming. The egg stage is around 10 to 65 days and the hopper stage or nymphal stage of around 24 to 95 days. And the adult stage of life cycle is 2.5 months to 5 months. The total life cycle varies from 2 to 6 months. Here you can see the locust swarming, and also the locust attacked on the pulse crop and other crops, and also the tree species, and feed voraciously. Looking into all these damage caused by the locust, an organization was set up in 1939, which is called as Locust Warning Organization. Then after it was merged with the Directorate of Plant Protection, Quarantine and Storage in 1946. The main functions of this Locust Warning Organization is, which conduct mainly locust surveillance as well as monitoring in the scheduled desert area, especially in case of Rajasthan, Haryana and Gujarat region, and which mainly coordinate with the stakeholders during the locust swarming situation. and also involved in issuing the locust situation bulletins, organizing border meeting, and also conducting the farmer field schools programs in Rabi season. Besides undertake control operation during the locust swarm situations. Now we can know about the integrated locust management aspects. On receiving the message of locust swarm invasion, the farmer has to take some of the preventive measures by making the loud sound, by beating the empty tin boxes or any metal plates or drums, by using radio or any electronic sounding system or any devices, by making these sounds, which avoids the landing of the swarm or locust swarm onto the crop land. By spraying the neem based formulation of about 0.15% EC at the rate of 45 ml per 15 liter of water on a standing crop, which acts as a feeding deterrent, thereby which avoids the feeding of the crop by locust. Dusting the crop with some of the dust formulation like phenol pass 1.5%, chloroferifos 1.5%, methyl parathion of 2% dust formulation at the rate of 25 kg per hectare of standing crop. If any ovipositional holes are found in the uncultivated fields, first dust with the insecticides and then go for plowing the field, which kills the eggs as well as emerging nymphs. If the hatching of eggs are already started and the nymphs are observed on the field, then go for spraying the biopesticides called Metrizium Inosoplia Acridum at the rate of 75 gram per 15 liter of water. Or else dust with any insecticides like the quinolfos 1.5% dust formulation or chloroferifos 1.5% dust formulation or methyl parathion 2% at the rate of 25 kg per hectare. If the hopper band is formed and observed marching, then go for igniting any dry grass or thrash in front of the marching hopper, which kills the nymphs of locust. Here you can see the locust nymphs which are marching on the field. If we ignite any grass or any thrash in front of this march, thereby which kills the nymphal stages of this locust. This is the picture which is here you can see the ultra low volume sprayer which is fixed onto the car for spraying. Here you can see the Metrizium. After the Metrizium spray, the spores of this Metrizium which enter inside the insect through this cuticle, then after which kills the this locust, and sporulation takes place on the insect body. Another method of management is digging of trench of about 2 feet deep and 2 feet wide in front of the marching hopper band, and then go for application of dust in these trenches. The dust like quinolfos 1.5%, chloroferifos 1.5%, methyl parathion 2% dust formulation can be applied inside these trenches. Or if water is available, then pour water into these trenches. If the hopper band or locust band is roosting, then go for dusting or spraying with the ultra low volume spray formulations are available, like Melathion 96% at the rate of 1 liter per hectare, or Phenetrothion 96% at the rate of 0.5 liter per hectare. Use these chemicals with the help of ultra low volume sprayer directly apply onto the hopper band. If the adult locust swarm has settled on the ground in uncultivated field, go for dusting with phenol phos, chloropyrifos, methyl pyrethione at the rate of 25 kg per hectare, or spraying with the melathion 96%, phenetrothion 96% of ultra low volume formulation by using ultra low volume sprayer at the rate of melathion at the rate of 1 liter per hectare and phenetrothion at the rate of 0.5 liter per hectare. If the locust swarm takes place in large uncultivated land, then go for application of dust formulation or ultra low volume formulation by using the vehicle mounted dusters or ULV sprayers. If the locust swarming is spotted and invading a large cropped area, the state agriculture department should arrange aerial spraying of ultra low volume formulations like melathion or phenetrothion with the help of ultra low volume nozzles which are fitted onto the helicopter, or by using the drones also we can apply the pesticides. While applying these pesticides, care has to be taken. Hope the video was helpful. Please like, share and subscribe the channel. Thank you.